Topic 3, Complex Numbers, Part 1. Okay, basically in Topic 3, you will learn about complex numbers. Okay, 3.1 is explain the concept of a complex number. 3.1.1 is describe between real parts and imaginary parts. 3.1.2, recognize that I equal to square root negative 1 or we call it sub negative 1. 3.2 is about demonstrate the operation of complex number, which are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Okay, then 3.3 is about demonstrate the graphical representation of a complex number through Argand diagram. Okay, you have to learn how to draw an Argand diagram to represent a complex number, and then use Argand diagram to find the modulus and argument. Then the last one is 3.4, write the complex number in other form. Describe the complex number in polar form, trigonometric form, exponential form. And calculate the multiplication and division of complex number in polar form and trigonometric form. Okay, 3.1, explain the concept of complex number. Okay, what is complex number? Okay, basically, complex number is a combination of real part and imaginary part. A is a real part. B, I is an imaginary part. Example, 3 plus 4i. 3 is the real part. 4i is the imaginary part. Negative 5 is a real part, and negative 6i is an imaginary part. 2 over 3 is real part, and 6i is imaginary part. Well, the last one, 5 is real part, and the square root 3, or we call it third 3, is an imaginary part. Okay, describe between real parts and imaginary parts. Real part is a real numbers. We call it number nyata, where the x or x squared is greater than or equal to 0. For example, real number is 0, 1, 2, 3, or negative 1, negative 3, and so on. For the imaginary numbers is where x squared equal to negative 1 or x equal to third negative 1. Okay, given I equal to square root negative 1, so I multiply with I will equal to third negative 1 multiply with third negative 1. So you will get I multiply with I, you will get I squared. And equal to third negative 1 multiplied third negative 1, you will get negative 1. So this one very important. I squared equal to negative 1 and I equal to third negative 1. Okay, important, eh? You have to recognize that I equal to third negative 1. Okay, these two very important, have to memorize it. Where I equal to third negative 1 and I square equal to negative 1. Okay, complex numbers. It consists of a real part and an imaginary part. A, real part, and BI is an imaginary part. Okay, where I is equal to square root negative 1. And I square equal to negative 1. Example 1. Express the answer in term of A plus BI. Okay, number 1. Third negative 3 equal to third 3 multiplied with negative 1. You have to split the number, positive number multiplied with negative 1. Okay, this one. 3 multiply with negative 1. Okay, you will get back negative 3. Then we convert the square root of third negative 1 into I. This one, third 3 multiplied negative 1, we can separate it into third 3 multiplied with third negative 1. Okay, so this part equal to I. Therefore, answer is third 3i. Okay, question number 2, square root negative 16. Okay, we can split the number, positive number, multiply with negative 1. So, negative 16 will be 16, positive number, multiply with negative 1. Okay, then we can separate it into two parts. Square root 16, multiply with square root negative 1. Square root negative 1 equal to I. Okay, so this one I. Therefore, your answer is square root 16 equal to 4, square root negative 1 equal to I, so it will be 4i. Okay, number 3, square root 7 multiplied with square root negative 4. Okay, square root 7 we remained. Okay, because this is a real number, then this one, square root negative 4, we can split the number into positive number multiplied with negative 1. So, 4 multiplied with negative 1. Okay, this one, square root 7, will remain. Then this one, square root 4 multiplied negative 1, we separate it into two parts. Square root 4 multiplied square root negative 1. Square root 7, will remain. Then square root 4, you will get 2. Okay, then square root negative 1, you will get I. Okay. After this, I will rearrange the answer. 2 put in front, then 3rd 7 in the middle, and the I. So, answer will be 2, 3rd 7, I. Okay, exercise 1. Express the following in terms of A plus B, I. Okay, class, try to complete the question A to H. (3.1) Simplify I power of n. Okay, this one very important. If n is an even number, the value of I power of n is 1 or negative 1. Okay, if n is an odd number, the value of I power of n is equal to I or negative I. Okay, notes. Bracket negative 1 power of 2 is not equal to negative 1 square. Okay, example 2. Simplify A, I power of 4. Okay, I power of 4, we have to put I square into the bracket because we know I square equal to negative 1. So, I square, then 2 multiply with 2, you will get 4. Okay, replace I square with negative 1 here. Then this one, power of 2. So, negative 1 power of 2, you will get negative 1. Okay, next, I power of negative 4. So, first of all, you have to put I square into the bracket. Then, you have to think about that. 2 have to multiply with 17. Then only you will get 34. So, I square, you can replace with negative 1. Then this one, 17. Okay, negative 1 power of 17, you will get negative 1. Okay, the last one, I power of 24. So, as usual, we put I square into the bracket. Then 2 have to multiply with 12. Then we will get 24. Okay, I square equal to negative 1. So, this one, 12, remained. Then, negative 1 power of 12, you will get 1. Okay. We can make conclusion that negative 1 power of even number, you will get 1. If negative 1 power of odd number, you will get negative 1. Let's check it out. This one, negative 1 power of 2. 2 is even, so answer will get positive. Positive. Okay, then this one, negative 1 power of 17. 17 is odd number. So you will get negative 1. Okay, then this one, negative 1 power of 12. 12 is even number. So you will get 1. Example 3. Simplify. AI power of 5. As usual, you have to put I square into the bracket. Okay, then 2 multiplied with 2, you will get 4. But the question is 5 here. So you have to multiply with one more I. After this, you can replace I square with negative 1. And this one 2, you just copy it and I. So negative 1 power of 2, even number, you will get positive 1. Then this one I, you mean. So 1 multiplied with I, you will get I. Okay, B, I power of 95. You have to put I square into the bracket. Then 2 multiplied with 47, you will get 94. Okay, the power of the question is 95. So you have to multiply with one more I here. Okay, then after this, you replace I square with negative 1. Negative 1 here. Then 47, we just copy it and I. Okay, negative 1 power of 47, odd number, you will get negative 1. Then this one I. So negative 1 multiplied with I, you will get negative I. Okay, the last one, I power of 35. We put I square into the bracket. Then 2 multiplied with 17, you will get 34. Okay, here is 35. So we have to multiply with one more I here. Okay, then I square equal to negative 1. This one the power 17. And this is the I. Okay, negative 1 power of odd number. Okay, odd number. So you will get negative 1 here. And the I remain. So negative 1 multiplied with I, you will get negative I. Exercise 2. Simplifying N expressions which contains I power of N. Okay, this one is an expression. A, 3i power of 10 minus 6i power of 53. Then B, I power of 12 over I power of 6 minus 12i power of 4. Okay, try to think about it and solve the question. Okay, next you also can try to find the roots of the following quadratic equation. Okay, by using the formula, x equal to negative b plus minus square root b square minus 4ac over 2a.